So why are fast radio bursts important? Well, as an astronomical phenomenon, they are not very well understood. We think that they're coming from a population of compact stars, things that are able to produce large amounts of energy on a short period of time. So these bursts are very, very brief flashes of radio waves. They're very bright compared to other radio sources. They come and go within a few milliseconds from random locations on the sky. And because they're very short-lived, you have to have telescopes collecting data very rapidly in time and also sampling the radio spectrum. So you end up with huge amounts of data to look for these signals. And it becomes a data processing and analysis challenge where you have so many what we would call candidate events. And so what we find is with humans, you quickly get overwhelmed with looking at these data. So you need to deploy artificial intelligence. And that's where these guys have come in and made really impressive headways into this problem and solved it, I should say. The students wrote some code that makes these diagnostic plots in a uniform way that's independent of which telescope it's coming from and so on.
These fast radio bursts are, the primary problem is that these are really hard to find. And that's why in the past 10 years, only around 100 have been seen. Very early on, we realized that we need something which can automatically do this job for us. And not just do this job for us, but do it as good as a human would do. Because we really don't want to miss these bursts.
So in the Green Bank experiment, for instance, that's allowed us to operate in an environment where we would otherwise get thousands of pulses to look through per day, just down to one or two. And so it just makes the whole experiment doable. Otherwise, all you'd be doing is just sitting there 24/7 just looking at these plots.
And this is what we like to do as astronomers, that we would like to figure out what exactly are the physical processes behind this, what all things can you probe with these objects, rather than actually just sitting and trying to find these objects.
It's such a massive improvement, and you're able to go through so much data and make so many more new discoveries and write proposals that are like, hey, we need more data because we've gone through it all now, and that's awesome.
It's something which we don't know about, right? Like we have seen so few of them that we don't really understand what astrophysical process is causing these amazing bursts. And they are so far off in the universe, they are not within our galaxy. Just the fact that we don't know what's causing them just generates this curiosity that, hey, I need to figure out what's happening. I need to figure out what physical process is causing these objects.